Hi, this is Alex from Groovy Entertainment. Today we got another CD to play for you. Today's CD is Superman Story 14 from 1940. So let's get started.
Presenting the transcription feature, Superman. Up in the sky, look, it's a bird, it's a plane, it's Superman.
When we last saw him, Superman had just rescued Captain Anderson from the steamer Madison and had found the hidden papers in the ship safe, just as the burning vessel exploded in a sheet of flame and a rain of falling shells. Today our story continues back in the offices of Perry White, city editor of the newspaper on which Superman works as Clark Kent. Captain Anderson has come up from the south after seeing his crew landed safely. And his sister, who is now out of the hospital, has joined him and Kent and Editor White for a discussion of further plans. Captain Anderson.
No, sir, I can't tell you a thing about it. The last thing I remember is beating against the hull with that fire getting closer and closer just beyond the door.
But, Captain, how did you escape? Your boat crew picked you up out on the water with a life preserver on.
Yes, Vince, how do you explain that?
I don't explain it, Jude. I tell you, I don't understand it at all. What do you think, Mr. Kent?
Well, really, Captain Anderson, maybe you were blown out of the ship by the explosion.
My men say the explosion came after.
Well, it's just one of those mysteries of the sea. We'll have to let it go at that. Oh, what do you got there, Kent?
Why, it's a package a friend of mine in the Coast Guard sent me. Take a look, Miss Anderson.
Why, Mr. Kent, it's mine.
Why, that's it. That's the one June gave me.
What? You mean to tell me that's the package of papers that was in the ship safe?
It certainly is.
Mr. Kent, where did you get it?
I told you. A friend of mine in the Coast Guard found it floating in the water.
Well, that shows you what a high explosive will do. Here's a package locked away in a safe. Bang comes the explosion and it's found floating around like a dead fish. Yes.
Well, never mind how it got there. The main thing is, we have it. Miss Anderson, what's in it?
I'll show you, Miss Anderson. First of all, letters from Pemberton to a man named Bailey, their representative out west, practically admitting what they're doing.
Let me see it.
What else?
Well, then here's what they said was a map of the North Star Mine, 3 miles southeast of Canyon City.
Well, what else, June? Why was all this business so all-fired important?
This letter alone's enough to put them behind the bars.
And here's the rest of it. A report from the government assay office saying that the ore from the North Star mine is absolutely worthless.
Well, what do you think?
And they went on selling stock after that?
Yes. That's when I realized they were crooked.
Well, Kent, what about them? Any ideas?
Where did they live, June?
They had a house out in Green Park with a Filipino houseboy, number 23 Durant Street. Mr. Kent, where are you going?
I don't like the idea of sitting and waiting for things to happen. There may be something out at their house the police haven't found.
Who do you think you are, Kent? Sherlock Holmes?
You never can tell, Mr. White. Do you mind?
No, of course not. I'm running an information bureau here, not a newspaper. Don't bother about me.
Well, I'll just have a quick look around. 23 Durant Street.
I'll stay here with June and check over these papers.
Good luck, Mr. Kent.
Thanks, Miss Anderson. I may need it.
Go ahead, Kent. Go ahead. Take all the time you want. But if you do happen to run into a story, just try and remember who you're working for, will you?
I won't be long, Mr. White. And if I don't find anything, I'll be right back. So long.
Doesn't sound like much, but it pays to look around. I'll just drop down into Green Park and have a chat with that Filipino houseboy. He may know more than he's told the police. Here we are. There's Durant Street. There's not a soul in sight. I'll just change back to Clark Kent reporter and see who answers the door. Down. Down. Surprise. somebody's room right here. And there's a desk, if the police have left anything in it.
Hey, what'd you do there? How you get in?
Oh, don't know me in my other clothes.
You get down. Get out quick.
Hey, put that gun down.
You'll no go. I shoot. I count three.
Make it 10. Make it 100.
1, 2, 3. Oh, what's the matter? You no get hit?
Come closer and try again. Come a lot closer and you'll see how bullets bounce.
Hey.
All right, that's enough. I haven't any time to waste. Here's what happens to little Filipino boys who play with guns.
Ah, let go. You let go.
Where are your bosses? Pemberton and Deneen. Quick, where are they?
I don't know.
Don't tell me that. I can see it on your face as plain as day. Where are they? One more chance. Telephone. Who's calling this out from the telephone? Answer it.
No.
I said answer it. And if it's either of your bosses, just act natural.
Oh, please. No go to phone. They say...
Go on. What did they say?
They say they kill me.
Not over the phone. Get that receiver. And do just as I tell you. Go on.
Hello, please.
Hello. Is that you, Peter?
Yes. It's me, boss.
Just as I tell you, what's doing first.
Okay, boss.
Look in the desk in my room. And back of the second drawer, you'll find another drawer. Get that?
Yeah, I get it.
Now, in that drawer is an envelope with Travis in it. Get it and put it in the mail.
Let's see where he is, quick.
Boss, where mail to, please?
Address it to John J. Jones. General delivery, Canyon City, Idaho. Got that?
Yeah. That all, please?
That's all. Anybody been at the house?
Say no.
No, boss.
Okay. If anybody comes and asks for me, say you don't know a thing. So long, sir.
Traveling under the name of Jones, is he? And he'll touch at Canyon City, Idaho. Much obliged, Sita.
Oh, you hear that?
Never mind. But get this. You saw how those bullets bounced off my chest.
Yeah, I see.
Well, I'm going now. But if you breathe a word about my coming here today, I'll be back.
No, I don't tell.
That's good. Because if you do, if you ever tell anybody, I'll come back here and bounce you off the sidewalk the way those bullets bounced off me.
No. All right.
Only be sure you remember it. Now I'm leaving you. Up through that skylight the way I came in. So long, Sita. What luck. Canyon City, Idaho. I bet I scared that houseboy out of a year's growth. Now back to the paper. You ask me, the North Star mining story is getting hotter every minute. Heading back toward town, Superman streaks through the sky. And presently, in the office of Editor White.
Well, Kent, this was the luckiest break I ever heard of. Canyon City, eh?
Mr. White, according to the map Miss Anderson showed us, Canyon City is near the North Star Mine.
What? You mean they're heading out there to the mine? Why?
Chief, I don't know for sure, but I can guess. They don't know about the papers being found.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, maybe they figure if they can get out there and ruin the mine, you know, wreck it for keeps, nobody'll ever be able to prove it wasn't all right.
Kent, I'll take a chance. You're free to go where you like. Hire a plane. Get out there. I want you on the spot when those fellows are caught. I'll notify the local police.
Oh, Mr. White, don't do that.
Why not?
Well, they're probably traveling by car. If we leave now by plane, the Andersons and I, we'll get there first.
What of it?
Well, don't warn the police. You want every paper in the country to get that story?
But what if you run into them out there? You and the girl and Anderson.
Well, if we do, I can handle it all right.
You? Alone? Well, who do you think you are? Superman?
Chief. Gosh, no, Chief. I mean, we'll be all right.
Okay, Kent, okay. Get your money and get going. And good luck. And phone if anything happens.
Well, almost gave myself away that time. Do I think I'm Superman? Well, as a matter of fact, Mr. White, I do. Down to the airport. Into a fast plane with Captain Anderson and his sister June. Over the Allegheny. Over the Great Basin of the Mississippi. West and still west to the cold, high stillness of the Rockies. When suddenly, unseen disaster comes creeping along the wings, invisible to the passengers in the plane's cabin.
Where are we now, Mr. Kent? Have you any idea?
Your brother's the navigator, Miss Anderson.
Don't ask a sailor to find his way around up in the air. Besides, it's black as ink outside. I can't see the stars.
Well, we went through a snowstorm a while ago.
Still in it. If you want me to make a guess, Miss Anderson, I'd say we're pretty close to Idaho.
Getting tired, June?
Oh, no. But I'm anxious to see what's going to happen.
Well,
so am I. Say, what's wrong?
So that was Superman Story 14 from 1940. So if you like, subscribe, share, and comment, and have a groovy day. We have another video coming out real soon.